20-year-old Clara Kachwa, aka Giift, is the Danish winner of an MME Award in 2024. She couldn't pick up the award in January at the ceremony to sit with us for an interview. Luckily, we were invited to come to London to meet her and to see her play at All Points East Festival. I'm getting broken up over you. Now I'm trying to erase all my memory. To be honest, you wasted my energy. You was good for some temporary love. Nothing more I can say it enough. No fake love, no fake love. Trying to get my own game up, yeah. So, I am originally from South Africa, where I was gifted the name Giift. And then when I came to Denmark, Giift kind of means something else. If you see it written on paper, it either means like that you're married, like marriage, or it means poison. So my parents was kind of like, well, we don't really want that when you're starting school and all of these other things. So they changed it to Clara, which it is now. But then as I got older, I was like, well, we gotta go back to Giift.
What was winning the award like?
I mean, winning the award was definitely like a big milestone. Yeah, it's just nice knowing that there's people outside of also where I'm from, Denmark, that listens and that's loving what we're doing. And yeah, so it means a lot. I think my big dream in music is to keep, like, you know, my own core and like having my life, and it's still being fun. I always want music to be fun. I always want it to feel new. I don't want to be stuck in the same. Like, I want to really always want music to be fun. I started off kind of on the guitar, and it was just me and kind of giving like homestool vibes. And I'm seeing myself doing, as I'm doing tomorrow, I'm doing All Points East and at Eurosonic and everything. I'm so excited to get out, and the music sounds different. It makes you move in a different kind of a way. And I'm very excited for that. So much for being recognized. Burn some bridges and I cut the ties. They was hoping they could get a piece of the pie, but it's only cut for you and I.
You just released Get Down and Loving You. Can you share more about the stories behind these songs?
Yes, so Get Down is basically about these last 2 years that has just been so much in traveling and all of these things. And there kind of comes a point where, not that there's a disconnect, but so much has just happened. And I'm so young, so this is like the first time I felt like, oh, I used to mess with these people. I used to this and this. And now it's like, oh, so this is how you get down now. I guess that's how you get down. Loving You is a love song. I don't know what else to say. It's a love song. I think it got elements that from some of my older projects I wanted to still keep, but I still think I had got to explore more of my producer side, and I had to kind of learn some new stuff. And I just think it's where I still feel very comfortable. I still feel very comfortable in the guitarist songs and the ballads and love songs and all of that, but I still took a step in a different direction. I survive for loving you. Only thing I'm living for, feeling for, breathing for, it ain't healthy. SOS, please, can you help me? Cause I always go the extra mile. And when I'm in love, I'm extra wild. I can't help it, but I always let it out like somebody cared about me. I started making music cause it was always a big part of my life. My dad played a lot of music in the living room, wherever, like I sometimes fell asleep to him playing the saxophone, all these things. So it just meant a lot to me. I love being by myself and making music, and yeah, so I think that's definitely, my dad is a big part of why I started making music. My mind is a big library. There's like a lot of books and it's like papers flying around the place and it's hard to explain. But then at the top of like the library, I would say there's like the space where everything kind of floats and it's vibey up there. Some of my favorite memories from writing is all of the stuff that I've learned from being in those rooms. I love going to rooms and taking some of that experience that I had doing some of those songs and then taking them into my own project and being, okay, what can I learn from these experiences? Because sometimes it's not music that I necessarily do for my own project, but I learn so much from it. And I think that's the most valuable thing that I can always take from those big writing sessions. I love the ping pong. I love going back and forth and, you know, getting to know other people and like, what do you want to write this song about? What is it that you want to tell the world through this music?
If you could gift the world with something, what would that be and why?
I think just the ability to let your ego go sometimes and just be free and love whoever you want to love and do all of these things. I think everybody kind of needs to take a break.
Ooh, beautiful. We'll be right back.